Does the coating on fried chicken make a difference in terms of provoking a blood sugar rise? In the following video, I'll test this and share my results. Who doesn't love fried chicken? Most diabetics probably assume that since you're eating mostly meat, it can't be too bad for your blood sugar. But fried chicken has a coating on it that's made of bread or crushed cornflakes or something that does in fact create a blood sugar rise. The question is, are there enough carbs in this coating to promote much of a rise, or is it minimal? We're going to find out. Benedict and I have been back from Africa for about 2 weeks, and I'm pretty well over my jet lag, but she definitely is not. Somehow she hasn't learned my secret to taking power naps, so when she gets tired, she just goes to bed for the next 9 or 10 hours. And she's done that on me again tonight. Well, what this means is that these days I'm on my own and making my suppers. So often in these situations, to make things easy for me, I'll buy some fried chicken, add a salad or some green beans, and I have myself a quick meal. Tonight I went to Golden Chick Restaurant and picked up some chicken, but I decided this would be worth a blood sugar test, so I ordered 12 pieces of legs and thighs, but 6 pieces have the extra crispy coating, and 6 pieces are roasted. And as you can see, the roasted chicken has no coating at all. Theoretically, it should barely budge my blood sugar. The fried chicken, on the other hand, with the crispy coating, is definitely going to have significantly more carbs, no doubt about that. But will it be enough to raise my blood sugar very much? We'll find out. Tonight I'm going to eat the crispy coated fried chicken with a good-sized bowl of green beans. And you may ask, why the green beans? Well, chicken itself just isn't much of a meal. Nobody would eat chicken by itself, and I'm not going to either. So this is my test, and I'll do it my way. If you do your test, you can eat just the chicken. But yet, normally you have to eat something with chicken, and I didn't want a bread roll. That would definitely influence the test. So I chose green beans, which do have some carbs, but not that many. And of course, I'll eat the green beans with both types of chicken. I tested my blood sugar just before this, and it was at 96, so if you'll excuse me, I'm going to enjoy my crispy coated chicken and my green beans. I'll wait an hour after I finish, and then get back to you to see what kind of a blood sugar spike I get. I'll drink water as my drink, so that won't affect my blood sugar. See you back in a little over an hour. Well, I have to say, that was a filling meal. I normally would only eat 2 pieces of chicken, but for this test, I wanted to eat more and make a big contrast between the 2 types of chicken. I just tested myself, and my blood sugar had spiked to 127, and that's not too bad. But keep in mind that the coating on the chicken was the only significant source of carbs in that meal. Certainly the chicken itself was essentially carb-free, and the green beans are a low-carb vegetable. So I got away with it. I stuffed myself with fried chicken with an extra crispy coating and kept well under my 140 limit at 1 hour. I'll test myself again at 1.5 hours, and I'll report that tomorrow. Now on tomorrow's test, I plan to eat 3 pieces of the roasted chicken, which has no coating on it at all, and therefore should have less carbs and create less of a blood sugar spike. I've not tested these 2 types of chicken against each other before, so I could be surprised, but with a meal of roasted chicken and green beans, there just aren't that many carbs, and that meal should be very gentle with my blood sugar. So I'll see you back in about 24 hours, but for you, it'll just take a second. I'm back. It's 1 day later, and I'm ready to dive into the Golden Chick chicken once again, this time eating 3 similar pieces of roasted chicken. Just tested my blood sugar. It was at 95, so very close to last night's pre-meal test. This chicken has no coating, so it has far less carbs. Once again, I'll be eating it with a good-sized bowl of green beans, and we'll see what difference there is in my blood sugar rise. I'll test my blood sugar at 1 hour after eating, and then again at 1.5 hours. See you back in a little while. I tested my blood sugar at 1 hour after finishing my meal, and I had a 103. Considering I ate a meal with so few carbs, that's probably not ideal, but when you peak at 103, you're not doing too bad at all. Clearly, the roasted chicken and green beans didn't make much of an impact on my blood sugar, which was exactly what I expected. By the way, the green beans I ate were these Del Monte cut green beans, and I ate the entire can. The whole can had 7 net grams of carbs, and since the chicken had virtually no carbs, this was a 7 carb gram meal, which would qualify as a keto meal. If you ate 3 of these chicken and green bean meals in a day, which nobody would want to do, but if you did, you'd be at 21 grams of carbs, which is right around the carb limit recommended for a keto diet. If there was a surprise in these tests, it was with the crispy coated chicken. I figured the crispy coating had enough carbs it would have pushed my blood sugar a bit higher than it did. I was expecting a blood sugar level of around 145 or 150, not the peak of 127 that I got. To sum up, for the crispy coated chicken, my blood sugar was at 96 before the meal. It peaked at 127 1 hour after eating, and by an hour and a half, it was starting on its way down and was at 114. With the roasted chicken, my blood sugar was at 95 before the meal. It peaked at 103 an hour after I finished the meal, and at an hour and a half, it had dropped down to 87. Whoa! What happened there? My 1.5 hour post-meal test gave me a number quite a bit lower than my pre-meal test of 95. Well, I guess my pancreas just overreacted a bit. With so few carbs for it to deal with, it spewed out more insulin than it needed to, and I ended up at an 87. Well, that's no problem. That's fine with me. Considering the test last night and tonight's test, we have to ask the question, what does this mean? It means that for me, I can't say about you, but for me, either type of chicken is fairly safe, although the roasted chicken is definitely superior. The roasted chicken looked smaller, but that was because the coating on the fried chicken added to the size of the chicken. And one thing we need to keep in mind is that very few people eat a chicken dinner the way that I did on both these tests. After all, how many people do you know that would have fried chicken and a bowl of green beans? Many people would want a bread roll or a biscuit with the chicken. Some people would have a large helping of mashed potatoes and gravy. Some would have corn on the cob as well. And all those carbs from those high-carb foods would combine to create a perfect storm of high blood sugar. If I ate fried chicken plus mashed potatoes plus a roll plus a large corn on the cob, it's pretty likely my blood sugar would have risen over 200 rather than the 127 I got from the coated chicken or the 103 from the roasted chicken. And bread coating is not just something we run into with fried chicken. Much frozen fish has a bread coating. The fish sandwich you buy at McDonald's, for example, gives you a double blow. First, the bun adds a lot of carbs, and then to add insult to injury, the coating on the fish gives you still more carbs. Add this to the fact that most people will eat French fries with the fish and then wash it down with a sugar-filled soft drink, and you have a blood sugar nightmare. Chicken fried steak is another example of ruining a perfectly good piece of meat with a bread coating. And to make matters worse, most people love to eat this with mashed potatoes and gravy. Plus, they put gravy over the steak itself. When you order a salad with chicken in it from a restaurant, sometimes they'll ask you if you want the chicken fried or grilled. The choice is obvious. For the sake of our blood sugar, we'd be far better off with the grilled chicken with no bread coating than the fried chicken with a bread coating. Before I knew I had blood sugar issues, I used to enjoy fried chicken with a biscuit or two and milk gravy. The bread coating on the chicken plus the biscuit or biscuits plus the gravy added up to big metabolic problems. Now, I know that by itself, just cutting out meats with bread coating is not going to solve all your blood sugar issues. But this is just one of many things we need to watch, and when possible, to choose less bread and less carbs rather than much bread and many carbs. Your blood sugar will thank you for it. Can you make your own low-carb bread coating for chicken? Sure you can. You can dip the chicken pieces in eggs and then roll them around in coconut or almond flour and then bake or fry the chicken. You'll cut the carbs significantly doing it that way over using traditional flour. Well, that's it for now. If you appreciated the video, give it a thumbs up so YouTube will rank it higher in its search engine and more people will be able to see it. And consider subscribing to this Beat Diabetes channel and then clicking the little bell icon. That way you'll be notified every time we post a new video. God bless, and see you again in another video.